Howdy and welcome to another Appsmith episode. I hope you are doing great today. Kevin Blanco here, Senior Developer Relations Advocate and your trusty guide to unlocking the potential of internal enterprise apps. Appsmith is proud to introduce custom widgets, so you can write custom logic, bring your own and preferred libraries, and create entirely new widgets tailored to your needs. Because development is about freedom. Take control of your code and build exactly what you imagine without worrying about boilerplate. Let's learn how to build your first custom widget so you can write code immediately. Alright, let's understand how custom widgets works. Let's create a new empty application where I'm going to also create a new empty custom widget. You can find the custom widgets under the UI tab here on the left, and you can easily find it by just typing custom. And you will see that it's under the display section. Let's drag and drop our first custom widget. And by default, Appsmith will normally showcase a sample custom widget. In this case, it's a carousel of tips. You can see that as you click on the next tip, it will scroll through all of the tips, but we're going to delete this to create a custom widget so you can understand all of the different capabilities and sections of a custom widget. The first thing, on the right, you will notice a new button. Normally, here on the right, you see all of the properties of any widget, but for the sake of the custom widget, there is a very specific function, which is the source. There you will be able to edit the JavaScript, the HTML, the CSS of this custom widget. Also, one thing you will see is the default model. The model is how you pass data to the custom widget. And also, from the custom widget, you can update the data model. In this case, you can pass it in multiple ways. The first thing is, like the example, in a hard-coded way. You can pass, in this case, for example, we have an object and an array of tips, which is what actually we're seeing here on the custom widget. You can also pass dynamic data from JavaScript, dynamic data from data sources. So this is a very powerful mechanism to pass data to your widget. Again, for the sake of this demo, we're going to delete this. And also let's go to the source so we can understand the structure of it. As you can see, this is a very standard editing experience, very similar to CodePen or GS Fiddle, where you have your HTML, your CSS, and your JavaScript. We also provide some templates out of the box, for example, for Vanilla.js, React, and Vue. So for example, if we replace here with Vanilla.js, we have the same custom widget functionality of the carousel, but it uses pure vanilla JavaScript. So again, I'm going to just use the React example, which is one of the most used libraries out there. And I'm just going to delete everything that we have here so we can build it from scratch. Now that we have everything empty, let's create our model. In this case, what I'm going to show you is how you can use React and a React plugin for image carousel to showcase a carousel of images. So what I'm going to do is the same thing. I'm going to pass hard-coded data, which again, it could be from a data source or from JavaScript. And in this data, we only have three URLs of images. That's how we're going to be building our carousel. Now let's go back to our editor, and the first thing we're going to be doing is defining the structure of our HTML. Now this is going to be fairly simple because React normally only requires the ID, the div where the application is going to be injected. And here you can also bring CSS and JavaScript from external libraries. Here what I'm bringing is the external CSS of the image gallery that I'm going to be using. This CSS is going to give format to my carousel of images, and that's all I need. Now let's go to the JavaScript section, and this is where probably we're going to spend most of our time. First thing we're going to need is define our imports. This is just as importing any other JavaScript library in your day-to-day development workflow. As you can see, I'm importing React, React DOM, and the Image Gallery plugin, which basically allows me to create image galleries with React. Those are the only three things that I need for this sample, but you can bring as many as imports that you need for your application. Now, the second thing we're going to need is very standard, is the app function. This is something very standard in a React application. And here is where we're going to be defining our application code, as well returning our piece of HTML. So the first thing I'm going to be doing is grabbing the information from the model into this actual React application. And the way I'm going to do this is very simple. All I'm going to do is define the structure that the image gallery component requires to pass the data along. In this case, I'm going to be grabbing the images from the data model. Okay. So how do we do that? How do we get the data from the model? It's very simple. Appsmith provides something called appsmith.model, and that's going to have the information of our model. In this case, remember that we created a data object, a data array of images. So now all we have to do is just pretty much define a constant, which is going to be the image URLs. And that's going to be the thing that we're going to be passing in this map function. So we're going to iterate through all of these image URLs, and we're going to return the structure of the original and the thumbnail. And that's basically the structure that the image carousel requires to render a new image gallery. Now let's return that image gallery. The first thing, as you can see, is we're returning the image gallery component. That default, that's the default component behavior. The items are going to be the images, which we actually define here. And then show index is basically a way to show in which index of the carousel we are at. Now, how do we tell Appsmith to render this component? This is one of the also very important pieces. All we have to do is call Appsmith onReady. This event is basically going to trigger when Appsmith is ready to render our component. And here we can pass parameters. We can also pass different information. For now, we're just going to leave it empty. And we're going to do an array function. And here what we're going to do is basically render our React application using React DOM. So all we have to do is React DOM.render, and we will pass along the app, which is our function that we have here. And the second parameter is where React is going to be rendering this application, which is going to be on the root element, which is this one right here. So as you can see that as soon as I implemented the Appsmith onReady event, we can now see our component, which is actually using the image gallery component and is rendering the image gallery and is fully functional. We now have a fully functional component, custom widget using React and image gallery. Now, the second thing I wanted to show you is how easy it is to define events. Any component can define events, and it's fairly simple. An event can be a response to something that happens on the application. For example, in this case, I can respond to the event on slide when people are sliding throughout the carousel of images. And the way I do that is super simple. All I have to do is, here on my application, define a new function. And this function is basically going to receive parameters and do something. What are we going to be doing here? So the first thing is that we can call the same reserved word, which is Appsmith, that trigger event. The trigger event is how we tell Appsmith, hey, I'm triggering this event, and I can define whatever name I want for that specific trigger. And then I can also do other things, like, for example, update the model. Remember that I mentioned at the beginning that you can grab the information from the model into your widget, like we did here, but you can also do it backwards. You can send data from your widget code into the data model. And the cool thing is that you can read that information on any other widget. For example, I'm going to show you how we can read data from the custom widget model that we sent from the custom widget into another widget. And that's how we do it, just using the update model. So what we're doing here is basically passing a new object saying, hey, this is the selected index that we're at right now, and passing the index parameter. The index is basically where we are at the carousel. So for example, in the first one is going to be 0, the second one 1, then the third one is going to be 2, and so on and so forth. It's basically the index of the carousel. So as you can see, that's all we had to do to define a new trigger event. So now if we go back to our application, we will see that we can define an action to this event that we trigger from the code. So as you can see, we named it onSlide. So we can actually grab the name of this event that we triggered manually and create a new event here on the events section. And we're going to name it onSlide, because that's the same name that we triggered on the code. And for this trigger, we can define actions, for example, showcase a new model or do whatever you want. In this case, I'm going to be adding, just for the sake of testing, showing a alert. And this alert is going to be a success triggered from the code. So every time that event is triggered on the code, this is going to be shown. So how do we bind this to our image gallery? So all we have to do is define the onSlide method, which this is something purely from the image gallery component. This is not something from Appsmith. And basically the image gallery can accept an onSlide method, and that onSlide method is going to trigger this function that we have here. And that function is the one that we have here, which is going to trigger the onSlide event and update the Appsmith bundle. So let's actually take a look at it. Let's deploy our application. And now whenever we trigger this, as you can see, whenever we are sliding throughout the carousel, we can see that the message is being shown because the code triggers the event and the event has an action attached to it. Also, the model is being updated. So how do we know that? Remember that we in our code, we have called this update model with the selected index name. So we could actually do something like create a new widget, text widget. And in this text widget, what I'm going to be rendering is our custom widget, which name is custom1, dot model, and the name, which is selected index. Yep, here it is. That's the name that we put it, selected index. So let's deploy our application and see if it actually works. There you go. As you can see here on the text widget, we have 0, 1, 2, because that's the index of the image carousel changing. And also, as you can see, the model is being triggered on each slide event. So what I just showed you is a very simple custom widget that uses React and an image gallery React library, and actually can interact with the end user, reading the data model, creating methods, sending back data to the Appsmith model, and also triggering custom events. So this is the first introductory video of this series of custom widgets, which highlights the most important topics around this new feature. But in the upcoming videos, we'll go in deep into each of these elements, like the data model, CSS styling, integrated widgets with data sources, and interactive widgets using your preferred frameworks and libraries like React, Vue, Angular, TypeScript, what have you, as Appsmith support most of the modern JavaScript libraries out there. Stay tuned for more upcoming videos by subscribing to our YouTube channel. Now go and build something awesome using Appsmith. See you in the next one.